everyone, today I, Akshat Srivastava, will talk on the topic History versus Peace and Development. In today's world, we see multiple wars and conflicts everywhere. They're usually based on land disputes, border disputes, racism, etc. Wars can damage a country's economy, make the people suffer, and incite violence. So what is the way out of this? The answer lies in history. In history, you can see examples of nations that used to be very prosperous and rich, but wars and conflicts made them economically and militarily weak. Whereas countries who chose development became prosperous and rich over time. Let's understand this topic with the help of few examples, starting with ancient Rome. Ancient Rome was a flourishing civilization that was a center of arts, learning, architecture, etc. However, internal conflicts and its division into the Eastern and Western Roman Empire weakened it. Furthermore, it used to over-rely on slaves. So when it stopped its expansion, it lost slaves and it weakened economically. Ultimately, different barbarian tribes came and attacked Rome, thereby bringing an end to it. The Roman Empire was replaced by multiple European kingdoms, and the Dark Ages, a period of cultural and scientific decline in Europe. Ancient Rome's trade partner, the contemporary Gupta Empire in India, was also weakened. The fall of Rome had adverse effects on trade, which led to its fall and the rise of the southern states. The Eastern Roman Empire continued though, as the Byzantine Empire under 1453, when the Ottomans captured its capital Constantinople and established the Ottoman Empire. Had Rome avoided internal conflicts or its division into the Eastern and Western Roman Empire, then possibly it could have survived and would have been flourishing like in its glorious days, alongside India, where Gupta successors could have kept North India strong and secure. Together, they could have made the world advanced than it is right now. Neither the Dark Ages could have happened, nor the Ottoman Empire could have risen. History could have been different altogether. Now that we are done with ancient Rome, let's move on to the example of the Gulf countries. Middle East and West Asia are in almost similar geographical and climatic conditions. Both are arid areas and are full of petroleum. However, countries like Saudi Arabia, UAE, Qatar, Kuwait, etc. are very developed. They're prosperous and rich, and they're also focusing on development, economy, technology, law and order, security, etc., which makes them good places for people to live. On the other hand, countries like Syria, Iraq, Jordan, etc. are not developed. They're not prosperous either because of terrorism or wars. Their people suffer from malnutrition, hunger, and poverty, and have to rely on aid from the UNO. Had these countries also chosen the way of development, then they could have been as developed and rich as Saudi Arabia and UAE are. Their people wouldn't have to suffer much. Now, let's move on to Germany. After World War II, Germany was divided into four occupation zones between Britain, France, United States of America, and the Soviet Union. The Soviet Union established a communist regime in their occupation zone, which became East Germany, whereas the Western powers merged their zones to make a capitalist West Germany. The capital Berlin was divided into the East and the West. West Germany improved quickly, and due to this, many East German educated individuals started going there. This became known as the brain drain, and this caused East Germany's economy to suffer and the standard of living to go down. In 1961, to stop people from going to the West, East German government built the Berlin Wall in 1961. It was heavily guarded, and those who attempted to cross it were shot dead. However, by the late 1980s, communism was falling in the East, and so many people protested against the government to make travel easier for them. On the 9th November 1989, the Berlin Wall came down after people armed with sledgehammers and chisels broke it. This was the first step to the German reunification that happened a year later. Since then, Germany has improved a lot in terms of economy. It has become one of the world's wealthiest countries, and it is a very good place for people to live and work in. Now, let's look at the final example, India and Pakistan. After World War II, the demand for India's independence increased. So, at that time, the Muslim League contested that if Muslims continued to live in a Hindu-majority India, they would be marginalized and they would not be able to develop. And so, they needed a nation of their own. Initially, the Congress rejected it. And so, the Muslim League declared Direct Action Day and communal riots happened across the country. Finally, the Congress had to accept it, and on 14th August, Pakistan Pakistan was born. India shared its assets with Pakistan and gave them 75 crores to manage their country. Thereafter, we focused on our scientific development, technological development, economic development, etc. and soon touched the heights of economic and technological success. Whereas Pakistan sponsored terrorism, anti-India movements, militancy, but failed to focus on its own development and became poorer and poorer over the years. Today, India is world's fifth largest economy that helps other economies like Sri Lanka and Maldives financially. Whereas Pakistan is 43rd of the major economies of the world and has to rely on loans even for its basic needs. Had the demand for Pakistan not been raised, then possibly the people of Pakistan could have been living as comfortably, as peacefully, and as securely as we Indians are. Together, India and Pakistan could have made a strong power in South Asia. So, by drawing from these examples, we learned that economic and technological development leads to peace and prosperity. Vice versa, peace and prosperity gives us the opportunity to work on our nation's development. The significance of history is to learn from our past mistakes and not repeat them. And so, I would like to tell my opinion that we should leave our conflicts and wars and start focusing on peace and prosperity. Because if we do so, our world will be a more better place to live. What are your views? Please share them with me. Thank you.